These notes are going to go into your AP Biology
comp book.
This is going to be our notes on cellular respiration. All right, let's take a look at what we got for them. All right, this is the equation for cellular respiration. C6H12O6 plus 6O2 yields, that's what the little arrow means, yields 6H2O plus 6CO2 plus ATP. These are the reactants. These are the products. C6H12O6 is a molecule of glucose. This is the oxygen gas that we breathe, water, carbon dioxide, and energy. So where do these things come from? The glucose comes from food, and so we need our digestive system. We use our digestive system in order to get that glucose from our food. We need the respiratory system to get the oxygen gas from the air that we breathe. Water is one of the waste products, and it's removed by the urinary system. Too much water makes our bodily fluids hypotonic. So water is a waste product. It's removed by the urinary system. Too much water makes our body fluids hypotonic. Carbon dioxide is a waste product that's removed by the respiratory system. Too much carbon dioxide makes our body fluids acidic. Carbon dioxide is a waste product removed by the respiratory system. Too much carbon dioxide makes our body fluids acidic. And then, of course, energy. All right. Today is the day that mitochondria go from being the powerhouse of the cell to the site of ATP synthesis by oxidative phosphorylation. So we no longer say mitochondria are the powerhouse of the cell. Mitochondria are the site of ATP synthesis by oxidative phosphorylation. All right, redox reactions are what it's all about. Redox reactions. These are all about electron transfer to make itself stable. Redox reactions are about moving around electrons to make compounds stable. It's all about electron transfer to make itself stable. All right, so the letters O-I-L-R-I-G, oil rig, helps us to kind of remember what's going on. So O in oil rig, O is oxidation. Oxidation is loss of electrons. Reduction is gain of electrons. Oxidation is loss of electrons. Reduction is gain of electrons. Aerobic respiration is a catabolic pathway requiring oxygen as the final electron acceptor in the electron transport chain, ETC. Aerobic respiration is a catabolic pathway requiring oxygen as the final electron acceptor in the electron transport chain. It is the most efficient pathway to produce ATP, and it occurs in eukaryotic and some prokaryotic cells. Aerobic respiration is the most efficient pathway to produce ATP, and it occurs in eukaryotic and some prokaryotic cells. In anaerobic respiration, energy is created when molecules other than oxygen are the final electron acceptor in the electron transport chain. Sulfur can be an electron acceptor, and then you end up with hydrogen sulfide instead of water. Energy is created when molecules other than oxygen are the final electron acceptor in the electron transport chain, ETC. Sulfur can be a final electron acceptor, and in that case, you're going to form hydrogen sulfide. So this process is much less efficient, and it occurs in the cytoplasm. Anaerobic respiration is much less efficient, and it occurs in the cytoplasm. Alright, so we've been talking about ATP quite a bit. Looked at the structure of it before, but let's go ahead and get a diagram in our comp book. So this is a simplified diagram of the structure of ATP. So the five-sided figure represents ribose. A little blue structure right here represents a nitrogen base, and it happens to be adenine. And then the purple represent three phosphate groups. So this is a phosphate group, this is a phosphate group, and this is a phosphate group. Structure of ATP, ribose, three phosphate groups, and the nitrogen base adenine. ATP stands for adenine triphosphate. DNA, the five carbon sugar, is deoxyribose. In ATP, it's ribose. Okay, so then we have this diagram right here, and I'm going to scroll out for just a second so you can kind of see what we got going on. Got this diagram right here that has a lot of stuff in it, and then I'm going to go over the information that's on the inside here. So, mitochondria structure. Cytosol is outside of the mitochondria. And there's a G arrow, P arrow, and we'll get that on the next page. Number one is the outer membrane. These little dots right here represent ribosomes. Number two, this is the inner membrane. These represent circular DNA. Number three is the intermembrane space, the space between the two membranes. Four is the cristae, it's a membrane fold. Five is the matrix, so it's the space in between right here. So this is intermembrane space, and then this is the matrix. All right. Up here we have oxidative phosphorylation. Oxidative phosphorylation includes the electron transport chain, which I've been abbreviating ETC. Write it out if you're not sure about it. So it includes the electron transport chain. And it also includes chemiosmosis. It also includes chemiosmosis. So oxidative phosphorylation, it occurs in the inner membrane of the mitochondria along the cristae. This is a star. It is a series of proteins embedded in the membrane that pump hydrogen ions, hydrogen protons, to create a gradient to power chemiosmosis. So we're on oxidative phosphorylation. It occurs in the inner membrane of the mitochondria along the cristae. A series of proteins embedded in the membrane pump the hydrogen protons to create a gradient to power chemiosmosis. All right, next we have the citric acid cycle. Citric acid cycle is also known as the Krebs cycle, different name for the same thing. It occurs in the mitochondrial matrix once pyruvate has been oxidated into acetyl-CoA. It completes the metabolic breakdown of glucose into carbon dioxide and water. Citric acid cycle is also called the Krebs cycle. It occurs in the mitochondrial matrix once pyruvate has been oxidized into acetyl-CoA. It completes the metabolic breakdown of glucose into carbon dioxide and water. So in this situation, four carbon molecule oxaloacetate combines with a 2-carbon acetyl-CoA to form a 6-carbon citrate. A 4-carbon molecule oxaloacetate combines with a 2-carbon acetyl-CoA to form the 6-carbon citrate. 6 carbon compound cycles forming CO2 and, more importantly, NADH and FADH2. The 6 carbon compound cycles forming CO2 and, more importantly, NADH and FADH2. The hydrogen ions and electrons picked up by NAD and FAD to create NADH and FADH2 will be used to create ATP in the electron transport chain. ETC is how I've been abbreviating that. The hydrogen ions and electrons picked up by NAD, and that's a little plus, NAD with a plus, and FAD to create NADH and FADH2 will be used to create ATP in the electron transport chain. Next. All right, so zoom back out to kind of show you what we've got.